Hi, I'm Jeff Luty with Houston Window Experts, and thanks for watching this video today. We're so glad you're here. In this video, we want to talk about this trend of black windows. What is it? Where did it come from? And what choices are available? So I'm standing here in our beautiful showroom where we have 20 brands of windows to choose from. We have Anderson, we have Pella, we have Marvin, Windsor, a lot of brands you've heard of and some brands you haven't. And so we offer a lot of choices and a lot of options. And the big trend right now, black windows, if you've seen that, it's really pretty cool. You know, it kind of started with Chip and Joanna. I don't know if you ever watch HGTV. You've seen that show where they, you know, kind of have that really cool, the plank and the kind of the white with the black. And it's gotten so popular, and a lot of manufacturers have kind of jumped right into that bandwagon and say, what do we do about that? Now, it's been around for a long time, but there's some new players. And so today I want to discuss some of this with you. And let me tell you, first of all, about the options. The options are going to come in vinyl. They're going to come in aluminum, and not your grandma's aluminum, the good aluminum, the new stuff that's very efficient. They're going to also come in wood, and you can get them, of course, in fiberglass with some products. So this is vinyl. And this window right here is made by a company called Windsor. And this gives you a really cool look, the black look like you like. And it also has these grids that are very realistic. These are called SDLs. Simulated divided lights. So instead of being the grids between the glass, like on this one, you can see the grids are between the glass. See, it's easier to keep the window clean, but it doesn't look as good or as realistic as when the grid actually sits on the surface. So this profile gives you a really sharp, I call it kind of a transitional look. It's not super narrow, but it's not super wide. And if you notice, the top of the frame right here, as this follows down the line, is the same all the way across the bottom. And also across the top. So you get this nice consistent look. And this comes in black on the outside with white on the inside, or you can also get it black on the inside if you prefer. So some people like black on black, some people like the black, but they still want to keep a white interior. So that's an option for you with this company. Now this is vinyl. Vinyl is going to be the most affordable version of doing a black window. So that's vinyl by Windsor. Another product that we have that's pretty cool too is a different profile. This is made by AMSCO, and this is vinyl. This is black vinyl. But if you notice, the difference here is that this profile is much narrower. So where this is a little more traditional or transitional, this one is going to be a little more contemporary. But there is a difference. Remember I told you how the other one, this profile right here, was the same from top to bottom? If you notice on this one, it goes wider at the bottom. Why? Well, because this is your sash. This is a part of the window that actually opens. So the frame is the same top and bottom, but the sash in the bottom has to open. And so you have what's called an unequal sight line, meaning this sight line is this width and that sight line is that width. This, my friend, is the narrowest framed vinyl window available in the United States. Well, available in Texas. And it's made out of really good quality materials from a company in Salt Lake City called AMSCO. They have a 70-year-old company. They have a great reputation for making quality windows and doors. And this is available in black on white or black on black. See, this is black on the inside and black on the outside. Now, before we move on, one thing I want to point out that's pretty cool. This first window I showed you is black on the outside, but it's painted. This one is black on the outside, but it's not painted. It's actually a capstock. And I should make a video about capstock. It'd take more time than we want to spend on it today. But basically, you have white vinyl window, and they have an overlay as that vinyl's being made that actually comes onto the top, and it's heat applied so that it actually bakes itself into the vinyl. So this is much more durable. It's harder to scratch off of this than paint would be. Because think about it, paint on plastic, you know, vinyl, there's chances that you might have some problems with it down the road. So that's why you get a 10-year warranty on that. You get a lifetime warranty on this. That's vinyl. Now, aluminum, okay? And this is, like I said, this is not your grandma's aluminum. This is the new stuff. This is an aluminum window made by a company called NT. They're based out of Fort Worth. NT stands for North Texas. They used to just be in the North Texas area. Now they actually across 9 states. They make a terrific product. This is actually a baked-on finish. It's called powder coating, where you actually have powder-coated finish. You get this black finish on it. This is going to come with the black inside and outside. And what makes it so special is this is not a standard aluminum. This is actually a thermally improved or thermally broken aluminum, and I'll get to that in just a second. So if you notice here, what I like about this window is kind of cool is you have locks up here, and you also have another reinforcing lock down here on the bottom. And watch this, when the window closes, it automatically locks. Wow, that sounds pretty good, huh? Nice, solid, strong. Hey, you know, a lot of people say, oh, I hate aluminum. I've got these old aluminum windows. Well, old aluminum might have been very inefficient, but I'll tell you what, it's strong. I mean, aluminum windows have been through lots and lots of hurricanes and they've held up. So there's nothing wrong with having a really good, strong aluminum product. Oh, one more thing I want to show you. Here's the same window, but this is in their picture window. This is for the window that, you know, doesn't open. You just want as much glass as you can get. This is 1.5 inches wide and 1.5 inches wide, 1.5, 1.5, and then the rest of it is just wall-to-wall glass. Gives you an incredible look. So I'm gonna ask the cameraman to back up a little bit because I want you to check out what I'm about to show you next. This is super high performance aluminum. And these guys are like the King Rolls-Royce of aluminum products. They make the absolute most beautiful stuff. It's called Fleetwood. And you can go to our website and type in a search for Fleetwood and check this out. If you've ever been to like Malibu, Beverly Hills, LA, where you see those houses on the hill facing the ocean with ginormous, beautiful windows and doors that are this black look, it's Fleetwood. I mean, these guys make the most incredible stuff. And they can make these doors that are 20 feet tall if you want them to be. They can be 60 feet wide. I mean, it's just incredible what you can do with aluminum. And it just rolls like that. Look at that. I mean, that's just beautiful how smooth that is, operates so nicely. And this panel is probably 300 pounds, and yet it operates so cool. So come into the little Fleetwood room. I want to show you what the concept of thermally broken or thermally improved, the modern version of aluminum kind of looks like. So this is an aluminum window frame by Fleetwood. And this is the same principle as what I showed you over here on the NT window. Aluminum is so efficient at transferring heat and cold that, you know, it's not really good to use for windows because all your cold would be transferred to the outside, all the heat would be transferred to the inside. So what's the solution? What do we do to make an aluminum window beautiful, strong, but efficient? Well, this is what they do. They actually make two frames. They make an outside frame, they make an inside frame, and then there's a divider here that goes between the two. And this is called a thermal break. It actually stops the thermal transfer of heat or cold from one side to another. This does not perform as well as vinyl does, because vinyl is like the best at thermal transfer, but it gets really, really close. And it's so strong and it's so beautiful. You can get such great big sizes of windows and doors out of it that this is the best way to do it. I'll show you the top of it here so you can see how wide that is. It actually makes a transfer break between one side and the other. And that's what makes aluminum work so well, especially in a hotter climate. In cold climates, even with this, it doesn't work as well. You remember that, what was that movie where the kid licks the flagpole and his tongue sticks to the flagpole? Ah, that was an aluminum flagpole, and that's what'll do it to you. But in a warmer climate like we have here in Houston, that's not a concern. That's not an issue. So this is the Rolls-Royce of the black look right here, Fleetwood. Now, we talked about vinyl, we've talked about aluminum, the entry-level affordable aluminum by NT, the super cool stuff by Fleetwood. And then there's like one option I want to show you over here. This is basically getting a wood window. This is Windsor. And we can do that same black look on this wood window. It is really pretty cool. Check this out. So this is a wood window. If you live in an area like some parts of the Heights, Montrose, River Oaks, Westview, Bel Air, where you've got the homes that are either older or they were designed to look older, but you want that black look, this is ideal for you. This is really great stuff. So the first vinyl window we saw, that black one, the very first one, that was this same company, okay? So that's their vinyl version of it. This is their wood premium version of it. And you can even put those side by side and they look a lot alike. So I have some houses where we use this on the ground floor, we use that on the second floor, we save money upstairs or on the back of the house, and then we put the money where it really matters. But what you notice here is the frame is white and the sash is black, so we still get a narrow contemporary look because even though the window's this wide, right, the part that looks black is only this wide. So this is a two-tone window. And we can do that with like over 60 colors. You could have red here and green here. I don't know why you would, but you, I guess you have a red and a white and a blue. Huh? You could go patriotic since we're opening up America again. This is the inside, so this is unfinished. But you see how you have wood here, so now you have the opportunity to paint this whatever color you want. Because in one room, you may stain it. If it's a study, you might have stained wood. Maybe in another room, it's white. In the kitchen, it's white, or other places. So we've got options available to you, and this is a terrific window. One last thing I want to show you about the black window look. Follow me over here. Oh, here's a door that complements that. Check out that door. That's pretty cool. That's a front door. Here's a little back door. See, we can do the same thing. Do the white frame with the black door. That's fiberglass. That'll last forever. No maintenance on that. But here's, I haven't installed this window yet, but it's going to get installed. I want you to see it. This is a Windsor casement window. Now look how cool that is. You've got the white on the side. You got that narrow black profile there. And this is just gorgeous. And guess what? This window actually opens. Instead of having a bar across the middle, you know, where it goes up and down, it has no bar. It has a crank handle on the inside. You crank it and it opens up like this. It swings out like a door would. So pretty cool stuff. Lots of options. Almost every manufacturer we have can make a product in black if that's what you're looking for. But I want to give you a quick rundown because it's such a hot trend. It's such a beautiful thing. And if you're interested in knowing more about our windows and doors, you can come into our beautiful showroom on West 38th Street, or we come out to your house, making a needs assessment, bring samples, give you some pricing, some information. I just want to say thank you for watching this video. If you're on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. And if you're on our website, feel free to contact me. There should be a form right there next to this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a great day, and I look forward to talking to you soon.